Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Jasmine. If you're new here, today I am partnering with Sephora. I picked up some new makeup for spring. You're not gonna want to miss these products because, girl, I found some gems. I got some gems, okay?
If you haven't done so yet, be sure to sign up for the Sephora Beauty Insider program. You get all sorts of rewards and perks for Rouge members, VIP members, and insiders. The Savings event does start on April 5th, so it's the perfect time to start adding everything you want to your cart.
We're starting with this Milk primer. I had to try this. It's a foaming primer. This primer also has turmeric. I believe it helps with dark spots. Ooh, this feels nice. It's kind of like a cleanser, but it's not. It's a primer. This feels pretty nice. It's supposed to give you a smooth, glowy base under your makeup. I definitely see the glow. This is very like ASMR. I think I applied way too much. This gives a really beautiful glow. It also has a slightly like, I won't say tacky, but it has a really nice texture that's gonna help your makeup kind of grip. I'm gonna use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Freeze Gel to just set my brows in place. I'm gonna let that sit while I work on the rest of my face and then we'll come back to brows. I'm gonna use the LYS bronzer to just bronze a little. And then we're just gonna blend this. I'm using a Rare Beauty brush to blend. I always use this. Why are these bracelets so shaky? I love using this Rare Beauty brush to blend up my bronzer. We're gonna use this brush to just contour my nose. Now I'm gonna try this Dior Forever Star Filter. I'm so excited to try this. This is supposed to give a beautiful all-over glow and it looks stunning on the models. This you can use on its own or you can mix it in with your foundation. I think I'm gonna mix it today, but I do want to see how it looks on its own first, just to kind of get what that, just to see what it looks like. This is what it looks like. I have the shade 6 in this product. We're gonna take a little bit on this brush and just start applying. I love the smell of Dior makeup. Oh, this has way more coverage than I was expecting. Oh wow, I was thinking like tinted moisturizer with minimal coverage, but this is not that. Like, it has a lot of coverage. Oh wow. Okay. Oh, this is different. I don't know if I've ever tried anything like this. This is giving bronze glowy goddess. I was not expecting all of this. Like, I don't know what I was expecting, but it was not this. I'm just gonna place my concealer so it can kind of sit on my face for a little bit. I'm obsessed. I'm literally loving this. I'm gagged. Like, I didn't realize this was gonna look like this. And I'm shook. I can't say I've ever tried a product like this, like with this amount of coverage and just the way it looks. All right, we're gonna do brows. I'm using my Refi brow pencil to just fill my brows in. We love a brow pencil restock. And I love the Refi brow pencil. As y'all know, it's definitely my favorite. I'm constantly repurchasing. All right, so we're gonna blend this out. I love seeing how concealers blend in with my like foundation or whatever this is. I'm loving how this is blending together. I think it looks really good. Okay, we're gonna get under here and then we're gonna switch brushes. I'm gonna have all my brushes linked below as well. I just pulled up the info on the Dior complexion product because I'm really curious. This looks way too good. It says long wearing, hydrating, liquid formula, light coverage, non-comedogenic. Light coverage where? This covers really well. I feel like it's light to medium maybe because I feel like the coverage was really nice. Especially for what it is. I was not expecting so much coverage. They're also claiming it to be long wearing, which I'm really curious about because typically products like this don't wear super long. Very excited to read that and I'm curious to see how long it's gonna wear on me because the way this may be my new summer, this may be my new spring/summer foundation product. I have a couple new blushes. This one is from Patrick Ta and it's in the shade, which is Vibrant. This is such a beautiful shade. I think it's perfect for spring and summer. And this is a powder and cream duo, so you get both two in one. I also got this LYS blush. Looks so pretty. This is so pretty. This one is in the shade Curvy. Like, how pretty is this shade? Like, this is stunning. I kind of want to wear this today. I feel like it kind of goes with the Dior product, so I'm gonna use this today. Oh, this is beautiful. Girl, I am here for this 125%. This is pretty. Do we see the material? While I was in the Dior section, I also saw this Forever Glow Maximizer. This is a bronze highlighter and I swatched it and I wanted to get it. So we're gonna use this as well. I'm gonna put it right up here. I have so much going on. So I'm gonna find a little spot right here for it to give some glow. And also right here, we're just gonna blend this. OMG. Babe, this is so pretty. Somebody take me to the airport because we need to go on a vacation. I feel like I just brought the vacation to my house. We're gonna set my under eye, but I wanna just go back in and blend out any creases so that way I don't set the crease in. I'm gonna do one side at a time. I'm using the pink Huda Beauty powder for this. This one is in Cherry Blossom, I believe. The shade is Cherry Blossom, and I love this powder. No matter how glowy the rest of my face is, I do like keeping a more matte under eye. I just feel like it suits me better. Before and after, I really love the way this looks. The Dior Star Filter has me so amazed, you guys. Like, I'm literally just thinking about it. Like, I'm blending out my powder and thinking about that product. Like, I am literally in awe. I'm gonna add a little bit to my forehead as well. I don't know what else to say besides I'm obsessed. Like, I love the way this looks. I also saw this eyeshadow palette and I wanted to try it. Somebody used a couple shades from this Natasha Denona palette. I'm gonna use Familia. If you know me, I'm a very simple eyeshadow person. 1-2-step is my method for eyeshadow. I like just doing two shades and just really blending them together. This is such a pretty shade. Natasha Denona has some of the best eyeshadow formulas out there. I love her formula. It just blends so easily. Like, it literally blends itself out. It's amazing. I mean, I can stop right there. We can stop right here. We don't need to go any further. I feel like this one shade looks so beautiful on its own. I feel like all of these shades look really nice against brown eyes. Like, you can't tell me this shadow does not look amazing on its own. Just this one shade looks so good. I'm gonna see what this looks like. I also want to swatch Intervention because it looks like a fiery, like, coppery tone. How pretty. Like, these look so good. Oh my gosh, edgy girl. I'm gonna use babies today. I'm keeping it safe because I'm literally going to Target right now to run some errands and I want to keep it a little bit on the neutral side. Oh, this is pretty. So pretty. Stunning. Absolutely stunning. Honestly, I feel like the quality of these shadows makes it really hard to keep it light and neutral. Like, even when I'm trying to be neutral, we're gonna go back in and just blend these two together. I did pick out a new mascara from Refi. The wand really just caught my attention. What can I say? That's literally it. I'm gonna hold my breath while I do this because I feel like it's a very delicate procedure, but here we go. Oh, this is genius. This is literally one coat and it just does everything for you. Definitely like a different feel, like a little bit of a learning curve, but I like this. We're gonna use the Bobbi Brown bronzer just to add a little powder bronzer. I believe this one is in the shade Deep. Yeah, this one's in the shade Deep. It's a newer like formula, I guess. They created a different formula. I think they changed the formula. The packaging is different and the shades look a little different. Let's get into my lips. I did pick up the Huda Beauty lip liner. This one's in the shade Rich Brown, and we're just gonna line. Not me swatching eyeshadow. Oh my god. I did not mean to do that, but that was really pretty, right? I picked up a new Makeup by Mario lipstick. I love the Bronx baddie shade that I have, so I figured I'd pick up a new shade. This one, Uptown Girl, which I am an Uptown girl as well. Uptown BX. This color looks really pretty for spring. Ooh, I love. I think the shade is stunning. I think it's so pretty and perfect for spring. I also got a lip gloss from Huda Beauty in the shade Honey. Yeah. This is their new faux filler gloss. They talked about this at the class that I went to, but they didn't have them for me to try out. So I was curious ever since, and I picked one up. I want to add a little to the center of my lips. Okay, face is sitting. I'm definitely loving literally everything I tried today. I think gorgeous, beautiful, everything is just like, wow. This was a good haul. Comment below your favorite product that I tried today, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.